She came down with a raging case of the mumps. Both sides. Y'all know what that means. She used to tell me that she, it made her look like a squirrel gathering nuts for the winter. Of course, she couldn't go to school. Her mother, at that, unfortunately, her parents were separated at this particular time. Her mother was living in Fairfax with her mother. She'd take a little dinky bus, which you can probably tell us a lot more about than I can. She'd take that little bus to the foot of Randolph Hill about over here and walk up and see Mom every day after the Papa went to work. So she took that ride one morning and walked up that hill and went into that mill village house. Mother was in the back making biscuits. I guess all the kitchens in the old mill village house was in the back of the house.
Yeah, sure.
And she walked in that kitchen and said, "Hazel, what are you doing?" And Mama said, "Well, Mom, I'm making biscuits."
Yeah.
"No, you ain't." Yes, and they laughed, and her mother said, "Well, I'm going to lay across the bed and take me a little nap. When I wake up, I have one of them biscuits." And they laughed, and she went and laid across that bed and went to be with the Lord.
Oh. That's a neat story.
Her dad did not go to work that day. We never knew why. He never told anybody, but he came in and found her. And thought she was asleep, started trying to wake her up, and you can imagine where it went from there. 6 weeks before high school graduation, she tried to go to college. Took a bus from here to Opelika Tech, they call it then. I don't know what they call it now.
Mm-hmm. Early Southern Union, wasn't it?
I think so. Mm-hmm. I think so. Bus would let her off here at Langdale Mill in the afternoon. She tried to work a full shift, walk up Randolph Hill, get a little sleep. Now, y'all can do that math, it doesn't work. So Mother did for the rest of her life what she did when she made that decision. She took care of her family.
Mm-hmm.
And that's her story. That's her story. Now, Daddy, Daddy is oldest of seven, son of a sharecropper. Now, in Daddy's day, discipline wasn't like today. That day's discipline is today you go to jail.
Yeah, that's right.
His daddy used a horse strap. That's that strap that goes from the bit in the horse's mouth up to where the rider is doing this. And his daddy would wrap that thing around his hand and revival would be on. You'd think he's leading the choir if you saw him from a distance. And then you would notice there wasn't one member in that choir and then they couldn't stand still. And didn't take long to do that math either. Papa whipped him with that strap one day and he said, "I'm going to town to get back and whoop you again." And Daddy told one of his brothers, "He ain't hitting me with that thing again." And I'm not using the correct language he used. You get the idea?
I get it.
He had that brother take him to a grist mill and he got off that mule and wagon at the grist mill and sent a message back home. "Tell Mama I'll see her soon. Tell Daddy I'll see him when flowers bloom in December."
Yeah.
Now, you couldn't say that nowadays because they just might bloom in December.
That's right.
Back then, winter was winter. And he walked from Clay County to Langdale. Took him about 3 months. Mm-hmm. He'd stop and work for a place to sleep or work for food and so forth.
Mm-hmm.
He found a room at the old Hunt boarding house in Fairfax, not far from the train station.
Yep.
And lied about his age at 15.
Mm-hmm.
15 years old, lied about his age, went to work in the cotton mill here. Running car slubbers and pickers, I think they call them, in the car room.
I'm sure he was proud to get that job.
Well, you go to a sharecropper. An 8-hour meal shift wasn't anything. Because they started the daylight and didn't get done in the dark. So to ask him to even work a 16-hour shift, he goes, "Yeah, I mean, you want me to work?"
Yeah.
You can even buy some popcorn now for a dollar.
Yeah, a dollar was a lot.
But yeah, it's a lot of money then.
I can remember going to what they call the kitty shop.
That's what I was going to say.
And you paid a nickel to get in.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you could take a quarter and get popcorn and a sucker and a drink and pay your nickel to get in. Mm-hmm. Also, do you remember that the milkman gave free tickets to the kitty shop?
I don't ever remember the
milkman. Yeah, milkman, you saw the milkman.
He
had free tickets. And he passed out to so he could go to the kitty show.
I'll buy that. My sisters were, though.
We went to the kitty show every Saturday morning. They always had their little continued episode of their cowboy thing. They always had these little cowboy movie things to start with. And then they had cartoon, and then they had a feature film. I guess it must have been about 10 o'clock. I don't know. But anyway, stayed at 12. And then your parents, they got rid of you for a few hours, I guess, and then they come pick you up, they leave you there, and you go to the show, and then they come back and get you. But those big old charm suckers.
But they also had this continued cereal,
yeah.
You know.
That's exactly it.
Yeah.
And cartoon. Had to match that. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Cartoon. Oh. With somebody on a cliff or something, mm-hmm. You have to go back
yeah.
And see what happened.
Oh, and Lynette Theater. Go downstairs at the Lynette Theater to their little snack bar or restaurant thing. I forget what you even called it back then. But anyway, they had the best lemon sour there was. So after the kiddie show,
love
you
lemon
get
sour.
Out to the outside go.
Yard or something like that.
Yeah.
Now, I hate butter beans, y'all. I really did. The brown, the big browns.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
gosh.
I
but when they were put on my plate in front of me,
you ate them.
I ate them. However, the refrigerator we had sat catty corner
mm-hmm.
in the corner. The kitchen table was here. Mm-hmm. We followed who sat on the end table.
You didn't sling them behind the refrigerator.
Well, we moved to the house. Mom was living here when she went to heaven, and they moved that refrigerator. There was about 2 pounds of fossilized butter beans on the wall and in the floor. If Mother had found those spreads, we'd have wore pillows tied to our rear ends for days. Eat them butter beans, boy. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
There you go.
Should we even talk about yes, sir, and yes, ma'am, and the whats that we get to? This? Don't start here.
You know, but by then, you know, the meals kind of waned out already, and they provided a good income for people.
Mm-hmm.
They took care of their people. You know, you can say, well, maybe the reasons why they did that was to keep the unions out, and I'll grant you that. You know, we don't have that conversation, but they did take care of their people.
Yeah.
And they sponsored the, you know, of course, the recreation team. They sponsored the Santa Claus.
Well, they built the community.
It is.
I mean, the communities did not exist.
Yeah, they were the mother.
The churches, the schools.
They were the mother company.
The clubs and the sports and
the mill. The mill was a village before the village came. The village came because the mill needed workers.
Yeah,
see?
The mills was built. The village built around it. Yeah.
So I've had to learn to give space to folk that maybe just don't understand.
Yeah,
big difference between that and folks that want to tear it down so they can be right.
Right.
Mm. And I'm gonna start on that the other day. I'm gonna start testifying. But I'm not going to do that then. But, you know, as we deal with people, it's important that we keep our patience.
Yeah.
And that we take the time to bring them to a place like this and show them the history.
Yeah.
You know.
Why it's important.
And talk about it, you know, in even terms. And some people are just going to reject it. You might as well get used to it. You know, some people just want to tear it down, start over. And ultimately, if we do our job in the presentation of what happened here, the majority will rule in our favor.
Yes.
If we don't do our job, we deserve whatever we get.
That's right.
So that's what I've joined myself to people that want to preserve. Mm-hmm. You know, tearing down is a good thing sometimes, but not always.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So yeah. Godspeed to y'all that's doing what you're doing, and I wish I could do more.
Can.
Yeah.
Well,
just like
do...
today, look at the contribution you made today.
Well, we'll see about that in time. Other people will judge that. It might be just a lot of hot air in some folks.
A lot of things that we have that we do need.
Maybe a historic marker so people will know.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And so there are things that we need to get done that. We have that we don't even all of us realize what all we do have. And so,
until it's gone, and then you know.
Yeah.